Good morning. Hello everyone, good morning and welcome to the ceremony of Jeffrey and Felicia. To all our friends, fans and guests who are tuning in us live on the YouTube live stream, a warm welcome to you as well. My name is also Jeff, the other Jeff, the shorter one. I'm the MC for this morning. And before we begin today, I'd like to give us some very important announcements, okay? Just housekeeping. Now, if you need to make a call, right, please move to the side of the aisle and then continue with your call and put your phone in silent mode. And then if you need to make another call, nature's call, right, if you look behind you, there are two exits marked at the end of the hall. The toilets, male and females, are behind there, right? And most important of all of us here today, you have one mission to do, right? 一个任务, that is to use all your TikTok and your IG and aim at this aisle here. If you look to your left and right, you see this beautiful aisle where Felicia will be marching in. And during the bridal march-in, we have one request for all guests, that is for all of us to remain seated, right? Please remain seated during the bridal march-in so that you can get a clear view of the beautiful bride. Guests tuning in from all over the world, again, warm welcome to you. Please stay tuned because we'll be starting the ceremony very soon. Meanwhile, Jeffrey and Felicia have prepared a series of video to retell their love stories. Please enjoy the video.
第一次见面在哪里？哇，第一次见面哦，我们一起拍戏，还记得是哪一部吗？
我第一次见你其实是在我家里，我看电视，我看2010年才华横溢初星秀的总决赛，然后我觉得这个男生演得很好，这样我也是，不对，因为他也是上海人嘛，所以当时我看那个的时候，我就会觉得哇，其中一个片段了，我真的觉得他很会演戏，
对，
果然拿冠军，
对，所以那是我第一次看到，真的。
戴着那个眼镜，戴眼镜，然后有点蓝，眼镜，眼镜，有没有想过，有没有想过有一天他会成为你未来的另一半？
你是说2010年那一个？
就是你看着在上面演戏的那个小男生，
不可能。
<笑><笑>
你们第一次接吻在哪里？
第一次接吻，哇，我的天哪！
没有立马回答。
我记得应该是在我的旧家是吗？还是在说不记得？旧家还是哇，我真的有点不记得。第一次牵手我就记得哪里？第一次在哪里？第一次牵手在哪里？就是公司，那你要不要讲？公司的斜坡，
旧公司，哪一个斜坡？就公司
Makeup Unit
的那边，没有，我们是要从下面走上去嘞。啊，那个时候就耍浪漫，明明都有车，然后就不开车，然后就大巴，然后去到公司下面的那个花圃，那个山，花圃，然后我们就走上去，而且我是在那个时候跟他告白的，是不是？对，那个是
official，
我在那个半坡上跟他告白，真的，就是那个11号12号吗？对对对。然后告白之后就直接签吗？
一定是先签的，我才告白。他签我的手，然后我就，
然后他就问我，这么大胆哦？他说你好像还没有正式表白，哎，这样很好哎，真的要
official吗？所以就是你签了他之后，你就说，哎，你干嘛签我的手？他签我的手，然后我就心里就觉得，哎，你还不 ask me 耶？你还有 my
hand？做给你最感动的一次经历或者是一个活动是什么？最让你感动的一次是什么？
其实凤玲，最感动的一个，其实我最感动的是每一次我做错事情的时候，他跟我说的一些话，是让我直接可以飙泪的那种。对，因为我觉得，可能我从来没有觉得好像我一直犯错，别人永远都是在指责，永远都是在批评，永远都是在谩骂，但是他会给我的感觉是，包容、接受，然后鼓励。对，所以这个是让我每一次我很感动，就是说，可能我从小长大的过程，就是说你很害怕犯错，但是你错了之后，你得到的是之前我所说的那一些。但是我第一次我感觉到我犯了错，他接受我，他包容我，没关系，对，有我在。
那是哪一刻哦？ 就是你们觉得对彼此从喜欢变成爱了。如果谈恋爱的话，一开始一定是喜欢。是哪一刻你发现这个人，你对他不只是喜欢，而是可以用"我爱他"来形容？ 凤玲记得吗？
坦白说，我觉得那个爱更深的时候，其实是我觉得我也在学习吧，所以就是求婚之后我发现什么是真的是爱，你懂吗？当然你之间的还是会有你的感情，你的爱，你的喜欢，但我觉得当你已经从你有更深的认知说爱真的是一个选择，对，爱不是一个感觉，而且是你真的心里知道爱是一个选择，是当就即使求婚之后这一个月吗，
差不多
我们也吵过架呀，有时候我真的想要，
第二天就吵了，是不是？
我真的想要，
第二天就吵了，
第二天有吵吗？有可能
没有啦，没有啦，第二天没有啦。
我就
记得好像，
第二天有吗？
好，不拆穿你们了，
那个星期啦，对
呀，那个星期可能有，
我快要把他景象给啊，但我会觉得我还是会选择跟他说我爱你，我选择爱你，我们是一对的，对，我也要知道说这个是个选择，所以在我心里我会更加的哇知道说哇原来爱是个 commitment，
对，
爱是个选择，
是
在我心里真的更
是一个选择，
扎根了，
真的，
对啊。
是我未来的太太，你好，未来的徐太太，我是你未来的丈夫，宝贝，今天是我们在一起第七年，我现在再也不会相信什么叫七年之痒，我相信七年是最完美的数字，这些年我们经历了太多高山低谷，我因此要感谢我们的神在中间帮助我们，指引我们道路。谢谢你接受我的软弱，谢谢你接受我，我爱你，我爱你，我爱你，我爱你，我爱你，我爱你，我爱你。你知道吗？你在国外那些日子哦，我觉得我生命中好像少了很多东西，但又感觉这20天我可以为这段感情做一些什么。说真的，我刚开始真的很不适应，但过后我越来越充实，于是就想利用这段时间回顾我们这些年的回忆。我真的很喜欢别人亲手做的东西，所以我亲手写下这段话，等到我们老了你可以拿来笑我，等我们有孩子了你可以拿给他们看自己的爸妈曾经也那么幼稚和肉麻。希望我能成为你生命中的支柱，聆听你的朋友，可依靠的男朋友，陪你一起走过高山低谷不离不弃的丈夫。新的旅程可不可以让我陪你一起走？无论前方等着我们的是什么，我坚信只要我们手握着彼此不放手，信靠神，我们一定能胜过一切。你是神祝福我最好的，我一定会好好的珍惜。不过都 Will you marry me？ 哦，还有，
还有，
回到我最初问你的问题。咕咕嘟，你愿意跟我有个家吗？
Oh my god！ 哇，
宝贝，你愿意嫁吗？
我愿意。
终于到了，我康复了，终于拍婚纱照了。感恩这七年发生的一切，有些不怎么愉快的，但我们从中成长。当然也有很多很开心的时光。谢谢你一直默默的支持我。在我最丑陋、最想要躲起来的时候，最想放弃的时候，你都默默地支持我，在我身边。谢谢你的耐心，还有你的不嫌弃。总之，无论生命有什么不完美，我们都一起去经历，一起去面对。我们永远也多了彼此。Two is always better than one. May we always choose to feel so and be so. Love, Bikini.
我们可以改变很多事情。旧事已过，一切都变成新的。沙漠开江河，荒野开道路，神所应许的影子居多。我也永远记得2019年的你，现在我们开始要建立我们自己的家庭，我请你多多指教。
请你多多指教。
我现在多一个身份，是陈凤玲的老公。我多了一份责任，也多了一个机会，可以好好的照顾你，宝贝。辛苦。请多包容我的坏毛病。
请多多包容我的坏毛病。咦。哈哈哈哈哈哈。
Good morning, everybody. My name is Jeff. I will be your MC for today. In a few moments, we'll be starting the wedding ceremony soon. To all our 2,700 fans and guests on our online stream, a warm welcome to you. Thank you for staying tuned to us. Just a couple of housekeeping announcements before we proceed with the ceremony. Right? Please make sure that your phones are turned to silent mode. And during the bridal march in, please remain seated. Okay? But there's one thing I request all of us to do. That is to point your phone. Fire up your IG and your TikTok. Point towards the center aisle. That's where Felicia, right, will be walking in with the bridal party. And there is a special hashtag for today. Right? That is Fell for Ming. So hashtag FELFORMING. Right? Toilets and restrooms are at the end of the hall if you need them. Right? I'll be back shortly. Families and friends, thank you for joining us on this joyous occasion in God's presence to witness the marriage of Jeffrey and Felicia. And today, we are joined by Ming Tie's family in Shanghai virtually through a live stream coming in right now. All right, we should be able to see the live stream coming in very, very quickly. And while we're getting that, right, maybe we can do a little bit of rehearsal. When they're on screen, they can see you. All I need us to do is to give them a very warm Singaporean welcome. Maybe we should try that first, okay? Like, just wave, right? 1, 2, 3. Oh, we can see them right now. 徐爸爸、徐妈妈，你们看到我们吗？ Let's just give them, this is a real thing. Come on, let's wave at them, let's wave at them. Well done, everybody. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we will be starting the wedding ceremony soon. As I said earlier on, during the bridal march, I request all of us to be seated. All right? Now, I've been wanting to do this for a very, very long time because we've got friends from the MediaCorp with us. So this is how we roll. Silence on set. Camera roll. Everyone point camera to the aisle. And now I'd like to invite BBTC's Mandarin Worship Lead Pastor, Pastor Ng Hua Kien, to officiate the ceremony. Pastor Ng.
Shall we all rise? No, sorry. Shall we all welcome the bride together? Let's not rise, okay? Just to catch and make sure that you listen to what the MC was saying now. Let's all get ready our hands and let's welcome the bride together. Little boy, shall we give him a round of applause? Yeah. And comes a pretty little girl. Yes. And now, shall we welcome the bride and her mother? Woo! Yeah! Woo-hoo! Yeah! Now, who gives this beautiful bride to this handsome groom? Thank you. Please do so. Mingjie, now you have all the responsibility for caring for Felicia from now on. Please take a seat. This is the moment. This is a sacred moment. This is a moment for Jeff and Feli. Mingjie, Feng Ling, soak in this moment, enjoy the presence of God and this special time for yourself. This is the day that God has created for the two of you. Family members, relatives, and friends, on behalf of this couple, I want to thank all of you for coming to share the joy of this occasion with Jeff and Feli. As in all Christian weddings, we do have a time of worship. This is also the couple's desire to want to invite God to come in the midst of our presence. And so, without much waiting, shall I invite Olivia and the team to come and lead us in a time of worship? And may I encourage all of us, let's join in together. Felicia, Olivia, please.
Thank you, Pastor Joaquin. Hello. Good morning, everyone. Hello, Jeff and Feli. Don't they look beautiful today? Today is a very special occasion, and the couple have chosen two worship songs. And worship is a very important part of their journey together. And so it is our honor to sing these two worship songs together. So may I invite everyone to please stand. We're going to get ready to sing together. Lord, thank you that we are able to come today to celebrate a very, very special occasion. We ask that you bless Feli and Mingjie. We are so proud of them. They've made the commitment to walk through life's journey together. And Lord, indeed today we will lift up your name with 1,000 hallelujahs. And we give you all the honor and the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Rocks cry out to worship. His glory taunts stars to shine. Perhaps creation longs to have the words to see. But this joy.
To the Lord, to the
this song is forever yours. A thousand hallelujahs, a thousand more. I exalt thee. I exalt thee. I exalt thee. Oh Lord, I exalt thee. I exalt thee.
God, as has always been your grace that's been with us. Through the valleys, on the mountaintops, you've given us the strength to go through life's difficulties. Thank you that we can come boldly to your throne of grace, and thank you that we are found in your everlasting love.
都是你。
Thank you. Please be seated. Pastor Sing Lee is supposed to give the exaltation right now, but unfortunately he's down with COVID. But nonetheless, he has prepared a video for us. So now for the exaltation.
Jeff and Felicia, I'm so happy for both of you. I'm so sorry I cannot be here physically with you, but I'm certainly with you in the spirit. I count it a privilege and a joy to walk with both of you for the last 2.5 years, journeying with you in a relationship issue and to witness how you have grown in the Lord till to this very day and even now at the marriage altar. I really rejoice with both of you. And I pray for today and ask God, what would the Lord wants me to share with both of you? And I was led to Psalms 127, verse 1. Psalms 127, verse 1 go this way. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain who built it. Unless the Lord guards the city, the watchman keeps awake in vain. You probably will notice that the phrase, unless the Lord builds, unless the Lord guards. The phrase, unless the Lord, is repeated twice. Now, what's the point? The point is to show us that we need the Lord. Nothing works properly without the Lord. And even more so in marriage, we need the Lord. So even as you begin this new chapter of life together, recognize that you need the Lord. Now, how do you express that? How do you appropriate the text? First, we must learn to focus on God and not on each other. I can give you at least 2 reasons why. First reason is because we are all sinners. All right? Now, Feli, if you've not realized, you're about to go to marry an imperfect man. And similarly for you, Jeff, you're going to marry a sinner. All right? Like I said earlier, the Bible said that we are all sinners. Now, second reason why we should not focus on each other first, because both of you are very different. Right? One is a planner. One is a last-minute worker. One goes by logic, one goes by inspiration. So when you focus on the differences in each other, it will drive you mad. Instead, you should focus on that which is constant, and that's God Himself. A Christian marriage is like a triangle where God is at the apex. And when the two of you move towards the apex, you find that you will move towards each other as well. And so that is what Christian marriage is about. We must learn to first focus on the Lord and not on each other first. And the second thing that I'd like to share with you from this text is you need to focus on what the Lord is doing. And going back to verse 1 again, unless the Lord builds, unless the Lord watches. So you need to ask yourself, what's the Lord building? What's the Lord watching? And in other words, what's the Lord doing? Success without God is another form of failure. I see many successful people regretting their failure in their marriage or even in their parenting or even in life. Therefore, there's a need for us to look at what God is doing first. And specifically for today's context, what is the Lord doing in each other's life? Allow me to model this for both of you. As someone who have worked with you for the last 2.5 years, I'd like to share with you what I see the Lord is doing in each of your life. So for example, Jeff, you're more than just the husband of Felicia. You are a blessing to Felicia. You bring stability to Felicia. You bring sensitivity to Felicia. You bring strength to Felicia. You are a blessing to Felicia. Similarly to you, Felicia, you are a blessing to Jeff. You bring spontaneity to Jeff. You bring service opportunity to Jeff. You teach Jeff how to serve others. You bring spirituality to Jeff. You are a blessing to Jeff. And we need to learn to see what God is doing through each other and give thanks. Now, I'd like to leave you with something that will help you to remember today's message. Right, that we need the Lord, especially for both of you. You need the Lord in this new chapter. And it's a picture of a father embracing the prodigal son. It's a picture we Christians are very familiar with. It's about God's love for us. But today, there's a twist to this picture. Instead of the prodigal son, you'll be both Felicia and Jeff. And our brother Sui Kiang have painstakingly drawn this picture together as our gift from our cell group for both of you to remind you about this message today, that you need to focus on the Lord first. And you need to focus on what the Lord is doing in each other's life. So that as you do that, you allow the Lord to bless this marriage. So may the Lord's blessing be upon you as you learn to depend on Him as you start this new day together. I shall now pass the time to Pastor Hua Ken to facilitate the rest of the wedding service. God bless both of you.
Right now, I'd like to invite Brother Sui Kiang to give the couple a special surprise gift. Yeah, round of applause, please. Thank you, thank you. 现在我终于可以讲中文了。现在呢，也是我稍微的把这个刚才蔡牧师的分享呢缩短一下，来讲讲他到底在讲些什么东西。明杰和凤玲，这是蔡牧师跟你们说的话。我为你们俩感到很高兴，很抱歉不能实体跟你们在一起，但我肯定。 在灵里与你们同在，能够在你们的关系上陪伴着你们将近两年半的时间，并且见证到你们现在的成长，直到今天步入这婚姻的殿堂，我感到很荣幸，非常的开心。今天这特别的日子，我求神给我话语来提醒你们。 诗篇127篇第一节这么说：若不是耶和华建造房屋，建造的人就枉然；若不是耶和华看守城池，看守的人就枉然警醒。这个字“若不是”这个词重复了两次，它提醒我们是什么呢？我们都需要耶和华，没有了主。 一切都不能正常的操作，更是在你们的婚姻更加的是如此。也因此呢，明杰、凤玲，在你们开始这婚姻的里程碑的时候，要认定我们都需要主。那要如何的应用这段经文在你们的婚姻里面呢？首先要把你们的焦点放在神的身上，而不是在彼此的身上。 为什么要这样子做呢？有两个原因。首先，第一个，我们都是罪人。凤玲，你晓得吗？你将要嫁给一个不完美的人啊。明杰，同样的，你也将娶一个罪人为你的妻子哦。所以呢，圣经才会说，我们世人都犯了罪。第二个原因。 不应该把焦点放在我们彼此的身上的事上，因为我们是不同的，一个是有计划的，一个是临时抱耶稣的脚的，一个是靠着逻辑，一个是靠着感动。所以，当你们把你们的那个焦点放在你们的不同的时候呢，其实它会令你们发疯的。相反的，你们更应该把你们的 焦点放在那永恒不改变的上帝的身上。基督徒的婚姻就像一个三角形，上帝在顶端，你们越靠近神，把焦点放在神的身上，你们彼此就更加的靠近。基督徒的婚姻便是如此，把焦点放在神的身上，而不是在彼此的身上。所以呢， 这是第一个重点。从这段经文当中，另外一个重点是要把焦点放在上帝的作为的身上。第一节说：“若不是耶和华建造，若不是耶和华看守，那我们要问耶和华神，他在造什么？他在看守什么？换句话说，神啊，你在做些什么东西呢？” 蔡牧师刚才有说一个很经典的一句话，没有上帝的成功也是一个失败来的。他也见证过很多的成功的人士后悔他们的婚姻，后悔他们没有好好的跟亲子、跟孩子跟家人在一起。也因此呢，我们在我们的婚姻上需要看到上帝在彼此之间的关系。陪伴了你们两年，我也很想跟你分享，在你们当中我看到神在你们身上所做的一切的事情。明杰，你不是凤玲的丈夫而已，你是她的祝福。你给凤玲带来安稳，你给凤玲带来更多的敏锐和力量，你是凤玲的祝福。凤玲，你是明杰的祝福，你给明杰带来更多的感动，你给明杰带来服侍的机会，教导他如何服侍他人，你带给明杰灵性。凤玲，你是明杰的祝福。你们要学习看到上帝在彼此身上的作为，并为此而感恩。为了帮助你们今天 的信息记得呢，我给你们预备了一个惊喜，就是刚才的那个惊喜。愿你每次看到这幅图画的时候，这是你们的小组还有弟兄用爱心所画的，你能够时时的想起到要把焦点放在神身上，要把焦点放在神在你们各自的生命的作为上，而为此而感恩。在此愿上帝祝福你们有一个美好的婚姻。上帝祝福你们。好了好了，现在是那个非常关键的时刻，好不好呢？我们以掌声来欢迎这对新人呢上前来，我们的证婚仪式就这样子正式的开始，好吗？耶、yeah! 欢迎你们。各位亲爱的亲戚朋友和弟兄姐妹们，我们今天聚集在上帝和众人面前，为了是要参与和见证新郎和新娘的神圣婚约。婚姻是上帝所设立的，人人都应当敬重。他向我们表明，基督与他的教会的神圣结合，是基督在加利利的迦拿婚姻上亲自领导，并经由他所行的第一个神迹所修饰和美化，且被视为人间至尊至圣的盟约。故此任何人都不应该随意轻率或任意地进入婚约，而是虔诚的、谨慎的、冷静的、敬畏上帝的心的心态，适当思考其婚姻被祝圣的原因。明杰和凤玲，以下是上帝对婚姻在设立的时候的那个目的。首先，婚姻是按照上帝的心意而设，为的是使人生养众多，并且让孩子都能敬畏上帝和在主的培育下成长，称颂他的圣名。其实换句话说，你们要响应政府的呼召，有更多的小小的明杰还有小小的凤玲呢在你们的家中，这是上帝的心意，你们同意吗？但是呢，孩子是神的祝福来的，有了孩子呢，那你真的要靠着神的恩典来照顾他们，来培育他们。婚姻的第二个目的是什么呢？婚约的设立是为了让上帝呢放在我们里面的神圣的自然的本能和情感能够正确地被引导，就是凡被呼召进入这神圣婚姻殿堂的人 应当继续在其中过圣洁的生活。换句话说，性爱只有在婚姻里面才是被上帝所重视的。而在这上帝所设立的婚姻当中，一男一女是一个最亲密，一夫一妻是一个最亲密的关系。而当你们在这样子的一个亲密的时候呢，赤身肉体的，没有保留的，在彼此的面前，也只有婚姻能够允许你们这样子的在神的面前这样子的建立这个关系。明杰凤林，我想提醒鼓励你们要保守着这个亲密的关系，不要让任何的东西把这个亲密的关系给拿走，外在的其他的不应该成为你们这个亲密关系的这个 联系在一起。就像你们身体上的亲密，身心灵也要亲密在一起。最后一个原因，第三个呢，是这个婚姻的设立呢，是为了彼此联合、帮助、安慰和相爱。无论是在顺境或逆境，都应该结为一体。换句话说，从今天开始，明杰虽然以后还会有很多漂亮的女孩子在，但是呢，从今天开始就只有这一位了，而且呢，她是你最好要好的朋友，同意吗？同样的，凤玲好开心哦，你这样子啊，凤玲，同样的，从今天开始，虽然还有很多其他的帅哥在外面，但是只有这位帅哥是永远你一生一世最好的朋友。而且呢，很多的调查显示，长久的婚姻呢，是因为夫妻俩的关系是最最要好的朋友，可以吗？可以吧？也因此，在我们面前的两位圣徒即将一起进入这神圣的婚姻殿堂，如果任何人有充分的理由认为他们不能合法地联合，请现在就提出来，否则从此就应当永远承认这婚约。你们等一下啊，也这里没有，还好，看看这边。哦，你的朋友都很好，很好。也因此，明杰和凤玲，我要求你们并嘱咐你们两人，如果你们将要在可畏之审判日那将心中所有秘密尽揭露一般，若你们俩知道有任何原因使你们不能合法的结合，现在就应该提出来。你们也要清楚地知道，凡不按照上帝的道而结合的，其婚约皆为不合法。好，现在请你们面对彼此好吗？明杰，你是否愿意娶凤玲为你合法的妻子，遵照上帝的对婚约的规定一起的生活？你是否愿意郑重地承诺要爱他、珍惜他、安慰他、尊重他和保护他，不论健康与否都对他专一、忠心于他、终身与他厮守？
我愿意。
大家鼓掌一下好不好？这个人很勇敢嘞，他做了一个那么大的一个承诺。凤玲，你是否愿意让明杰成为你合法的丈夫，遵照上帝对婚约的规定一起生活？你是否愿意郑重地承诺地爱他、珍惜他、安慰他、尊荣他和保护他，不论健康与否都对他专一、忠心于他、终身与他相守？
我愿意。
我许明杰愿意娶你陈凤玲为我合法的妻子，遵照上帝的旨意，我承诺至今以后无论任何境况，安居或困苦，富足或贫穷，健康或生病，我都敬爱你，珍惜你，直到终身。我为此真心立约不悔。阿门。
我陈凤玲愿意嫁给你徐明杰，让你成为我合法的丈夫，遵照上帝的旨意，我承诺至今以后无论任何境况，安居或困苦，富足或贫穷，健康或生病，我都敬爱你，珍惜你，直到终生。我为此真心立约不悔。阿门。
为了要纪念他们今天在上帝面前所立的婚约，这新人将交换戒指。
我将这戒指套在你的手指上，在上帝众人面前，作为我们婚约里的信物，奉圣父、圣子和圣灵的名，阿门。
我把这戒指套在你的手指上，在上帝及众人面前，作为我们婚约里的信物，奉圣父、圣子和圣灵的名求，阿门。
我们一起来祷告好吗？永生的上帝，创造和眷顾世人的主，所有属灵恩惠的供应者，永活生命的根源，求你赐给这对仆人祝福，就是我们奉你的名祝福的这新人，求你使他们得以持守今日所立的婚约，并保守他们彼此忠心相守。这互相交换的戒指是这婚约的象征与信物，求你使他们 永远彼此相爱，平安厮守，并按你的教导生活，奉主耶稣基督的圣名求，阿们。上帝所结合的人是不能分开他们的，既然名节和奉灵已在上帝和众人面前同意结回夫妇，并彼此立下婚约，也借交换戒指和联手彼此宣誓，我谨此奉圣父圣子和圣灵的名宣告他们成为夫妇，阿们。来，你们彼此面对一下好不好？明杰，这是你最重要的时刻，你们给他们掌声好不好？你可以亲你的新娘了。够吗？够吗？还要不要再来一次啊？很好，很好。现在呢，我想一起呢，领这对新人呢，一起的来以夫妻的名义啊，守着这个圣餐。这是一个私人的仪式，我请大家呢，暂时保持安静。让这对新人呢与神有独处的时间。现在是他们签这个结婚证书的时候，我想邀请两位见证人也上台来好吗？Felicia 的妈妈还有
Not sure if you know this, My love is now, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word. So as long as I live I love you, we'll never know you. You look so beautiful in white, and from now to my very last breath this day I'll cherish. You look so like you and I did. And if she falls in love, we'll let her go. I'll walk her down the aisle. She looks so beautiful in white. Yeah, yeah. So beautiful in white. Oh, as long as I live, I love you. We'll have it all with you. You look so beautiful in white. And from now till my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. Na 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 na. So beautiful.
Thank you. Now, can 在圣洁的婚约里结为一体，祈求你赐给他们恩典，好让他们能遵照你的圣言度过婚姻生活，加添力量给他们，好让他们不断彼此保持真诚纯洁的情感，在他们面对试炼和诱惑时保守和捍卫他们，帮助他们。 使他们能够以信心穿透这个世界，去到你的面前，融入你的神圣教会，以爱心互相服侍，让他们可以享受你属天的祝福。奉你的儿子，我们永活的神与圣灵一位上帝永远掌权的主耶稣基督的名祷告，阿门。 各位亲戚朋友和弟兄姐妹们，让我们一起欢迎徐明杰、康丽。有一份爱从天而来，比山高，比。
测不透，摸不着，却看得见。
Ladies and gentlemen, please put our hands together and welcome our new couple for today. I'd like to invite Mr. and Mrs. Jeffrey Shi, Ning Jie on the stage. Come on, let's give them a round of applause again, one more time. Please be seated. How are you guys feeling?
Nervous.
Yeah. All right. The couple would like now to express their gratitude and thanks to their friends and family members. We'll start with Ming Jie first. Okay.
First, I want to thank God, and then 给了我这么棒的礼物，我会一生用我的一生去守护。然后我要谢谢伯母。哦，对 ，NG， 伯母今天是最后一次叫，我现在要叫你妈。虽然我之前一直口口声声叫你伯母，其实我早就把你当成我新加坡的家人。谢谢你在我最低落的时候煮了一碗面给我吃，让我感觉到有家人。真的很感谢你培养出那么棒的女儿，我一定会好好的爱她，照顾她，我也会更加的爱你。对，谢谢你。然后我要谢谢我上海的家人，我的爸爸妈妈，我爸爸妈妈一直很期待我结婚，妈妈前两天还睡不着。我想说，
我要先谢谢我的爸爸。从小开始，爸爸就一个人在工作，每一天都准时起来上班，早出晚归。他为这个家庭付出了他大半生的生命，就为了给我和这个家很好的生活。我爸不是一个会表达的人，从小跟我爸的话也很少，但是爸，我爱你。妈妈，我的妈妈从小培养我，在家里面照顾我，把家弄得很美。我不管有什么样的梦想，什么样的兴趣，她都支持我，鼓励我。我今天能站在这里，甚至有一份我所爱的事业，少不了你的功劳，非常谢谢你的付出。妈，你别哭，我看你哭我就受不了。谢谢你，希望可以赶快回家抱抱你们，想你们。接下来凤玲还有一些话要对你们说。
哦，爸爸妈妈，谢谢你们。我认识明杰七年，我特别感动。我知道你们都把我当你们自己女儿看待，谢谢你们。每次我生日的时候都这么爱我，花了这么多，就希望我能开心。不是礼物的贵重，而是我觉得是你们的心意。然后我想说的是，能认识到明杰是我的福分。谢谢爸爸，你真的从小到大都一直很保守明杰，一直保护他，你是个好爸爸。然后妈妈，谢谢你，每次我跟明杰吵架，你都是站在我这一边。谢谢你把我当女儿看待，然后我会好好珍惜明杰，然后我们也会很希望快快的可以来到上海，和大家聚一聚，然后也想跟上海的所有亲戚朋友们说声 hello， 希望很快可以见面。谢谢爸爸妈妈。
哎呀，你们想要建立自己的小家庭，爸爸妈妈永远祝福你们，不能宝贝，妈妈永远站在你身边，感谢主这个安排。
然后现在我也想借这个机会也谢谢我妈妈。Thank you, mommy. Thank you, mommy, for bringing me up, bringing me and Zezé up. We love you, and it must have been very hard on you. So many years of staying at home, taking care of us.And I know that you have sacrificed a lot as well. I just want to say that, Mommy, I love you a lot. and you're an awesome mom. I love you.
Oh.
And now we have a very special video message coming all the way from Shanghai for the couple.
感谢上帝，在他的旨意中，把徐明杰跟陈凤玲两个年轻人集合在一起，成为夫妻。我也感谢各位长辈、亲戚、朋友，你们抽出宝贵的时间。 参加徐明杰、陈凤玲的婚礼，你们的到来使今天的婚宴更加辉煌。我也特别感谢教会的牧师和弟兄姐妹们，你们的祝福是永恒属天的祝福。下面我对明杰说：“儿子，你是最棒的。” 我对儿媳凤玲说：“上帝把天使般美丽的凤玲赐给我们明杰家，是神对我们最大的祝福。在这里，我要感谢亲家母，养育这么优秀的凤玲，您辛苦了。我想今天你和我们一样是最开心的日子，明杰、凤玲。” 你们从相恋相知相爱，终于走进结婚殿堂。这是你们相爱的见证。婚姻是神设立的，愿你们的爱情比酒更美，比膏油更加清香，比蜂房滴下的蜜甘甜，比极贵的珍宝更加宝贵。 愿我们的神将天上全部的福地里所藏的福，都赐给你们。Amen. 感谢主。
陈凤玲，祝你们新婚快乐啊，白头到老啊，恭喜你们啊！ 对父母好一点，对母亲好一点啊！啊。See,
that was a reprise that I wasn't clued in on. All right, it has been a heartfelt and inspiring morning to remember God's love for us, and thank you, Jeffrey and Felicia, for living out your faith. And now, for our viewers that are on live stream right now, we will be ending the live stream in a couple of minutes' time. Thank you so much for staying with us. We hope you enjoyed the wedding, and we also hope that you've been inspired as well. Now, I'd like to invite Pastor Joaquin to come on stage to give us to say grace for the food and the reception that we're going to have later.
Dear Lord, we thank you for this beautiful occasion. We pray, God, that may you be glorified in all the things that we have done together, and may you continue to be glorified in Jeff and Felicia's wedding. We thank you for the food that you provided for us. We pray, God, you bless it for the nourishing body and the time that we have together. Let it be a special celebration moment that we have in this with this couple. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You've been a wonderful audience, right? I would like to give us some instruction and dismiss you all for the refreshment. But before I do that, there is a car by the number of SNG.